Now to an important University of Minnesota milestone, more than a century in the making. Today, the U named its first ever black female director. Our Charmaine Nero was on campus to watch history unfold, and she joins us now with more on the day's events. Hi, Charmaine.
That's right, Reiner. Dr. Blakey started this historic position in July, and as she told us today, it's a dream come true to hold this position in her home state.
Being in this office on the University of Minnesota campus is something Dr. Joan Blakey never imagined.
Absolutely not.
Growing up in St. Paul.
I grew up wanting to be a judge. I've always felt a strong pull about justice.
Dr. Blakey continued the path toward justice, going on to earn a Bachelor's of Science and Master's of Social Work degree from the University of Minnesota, and later receiving her doctorate from the University of Chicago's School of Social Service Administration. With over 25 years of experience making stops in Wisconsin and New Orleans, coming home was always her goal.
I am the fourth generation Minnesotan. My mom was born here in northern Minnesota, in Lindstrom, Minnesota. My great-grandfather is very famous. He's worked on buildings in St. Paul.
Dr. Blakey specializes in child advocacy, diversity, equity, and inclusion, and anti-racism initiatives. She says fairness has always been a core value.
It was those words like social justice, marginalized populations, advocating for people who, you know, couldn't advocate for themselves, that really drew me to the profession.
While she credits mentors and her family for helping her on her journey, she's inspiring the next generation of leaders.
It's important to see that, even if I never interact with those students, seeing me as the director, seeing my face, my brown face, is really important in terms of saying that, okay, she can do it, I can do it.
To embrace different perspectives and think big.
My motto is try to leave things better than what I found it.
Now, a ceremony was held today on the campus for Dr. Blakey. Friends, family, and colleagues tell us that they're there to celebrate her historic role. Back to you.
All right, great story. Thank you, Charmaine.